So I would like to thank all the devotees to give me the opportunity and good fortune to speak something on Bhagavad Gita. Although many senior devotees are present here, I am not qualified to instruct, but I just can share whatever I am learning from acharyas for my purification. So I need blessings of all devotees. Hare Krishna.
We feel blessed.
So today we are going to discuss one shloka from the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, shloka number 51. The chapter is the universal form. So please try to repeat after me. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Arjun uvacha drishtvedam manusham rupam tava somyam janardana idanimasmi samvritta sacheta prakritim gataha drishtvedam manusham rupam tava somyam janardana idanimasmi samvritta sacheta prakritim gataha. Let's try to recite. Drishtvedam manusham rupam tava somyam janardana idanimasmi samvrittah sacheta prakritim gatah. Arjun vacha drishtvedam manusham rupam tava somyam janardana idanimasmi samvritta sacheta prakritim gatah. Arjun vacha drishtvedam manusham rupam tava somyam janardana idanimasmi samvrittah sacheta prakritim gatah. Mataji. Arjun vacha drishtvedam manusham rupam tava somyam janardana idanimasmi samvrittah sacheta prakritim gatah. Word to word meaning. Arjuna uvacha. Arjun said, drishtva, seeing, idam, this, manusham, human, rupam, form, tava, your, somyam, very beautiful, Janardana, O chastiser of the enemies, idanim, now, asmi, I am, samvrittaha, settled, sachetaha, in my consciousness, prakritim, to my own nature, gataha, return. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Translation. When Arjun thus saw Krishna in his original form, he said, O Janardhan, seeing this human-like form so very beautiful, I am now composed in mind and I am restored to my original nature. Purport. Here the words Manushyam Rupam clearly indicate the Supreme Personality of Godhead to be the originally two-handed. Those who deride Krishna as if he were an ordinary person are shown here to be ignorant of his divine nature. If Krishna is like an ordinary human being, then how is it possible for him to show the universal form and again to show the four-handed Narayan form? So it is very clearly stated in Bhagavad Gita that one who thinks that Krishna is an ordinary person and who misguides the reader by claiming that it is the impersonal Brahman within Krishna speaking is doing the greatest injustice. Krishna has actually shown his universal form and his four-handed Vishnu form. So how can he be an ordinary human being? A pure devotee is not confused by misguiding commentaries on Bhagavad Gita because he knows what is what. The original verses of Bhagavad Gita are as clear as the sun. They do not require lamp light from foolish commentators. Om Agyanti Mirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namah Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupah Kadamayam Dadati Supadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru, Shri Utapadakamalam, Shri Gurun Vaishnamascha, Shri Rupam Sagri Jatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam, Tam Sajivam, Sadvaitam Savadutam, Parijana Saitam, Krishna Chaitanya Devam, Shri Radha Krishna Padan, Sahagana Lalita, Shri Vishakhanvitascha. He Krishna Karuna Sindho, Dina Bandho Jagatpate, Gopesh Gopika Kanta, Radha Kanta Namastute, Tapta Kanchan Gorangi, Shri Radhe Vindavaneshwari, Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Haripriya Vancha Kalpata Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bevacha Patita Nam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namah Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna. So, this chapter of Bhagavad Gita is entitled The Universal Form. So, before, in the 10th chapter, Lord Krishna is describing his opulences. And when Arjun hears all the opulences of Lord Krishna, then he becomes very much impressed and then he requests Lord Krishna to show his form, which is having all these opulences. Actually, in the beginning, purports only, Srila Prabhupada says that this universal form of Lord Krishna, this is actually temporary. It is not like other Vishnu forms of Lord Krishna, which are eternally present in spiritual world. This, just like this material world, is sometime manifests and sometime unmanifests. Similarly, this universal form of Lord Krishna is also manifest and unmanifest. And this form is not eternally situated in the spiritual world. So, devotees are actually not interested to see this universal form because they have faith. Like when Arjun hears the opulences of Krishna, he doesn't ask Krishna to show his universal form for confirmation for himself. He believes actually. But Arjun asks Krishna to show his universal form for all other people of this material world because in this Kali Yuga, there are so many people who claim to be God. So to become careful not to be cheated by such misinterpretations or misrepresentations of Supreme Lord, Arjun requests Krishna to show his universal form. So Prabhupada writes in one of the purport of this chapter that this universal form Arjuna requested Krishna to show so that in future those who will claim to be God or Krishna, they will be requested to show the universal form or four-handed form if they can. So that's why Krishna requested Arjun requested Krishna to show this universal form. So here Prabhupada says that this word Manusham Rupam, actually this word clearly indicates the Supreme Personality of Godhead to be originally two-handed. But we can see that so many people, they misinterpret the words of the Vedic scripture. So here Arjuna is saying Manusham Rupam, like human form. So someone can very easily misinterpret on this word that okay, yeah, Krishna has this human form, that means Krishna is also like ordinary human being. But actually we cannot misinterpret like this, because in the background we see that previously Krishna showed his universal form and then four-handed Vishnu form to Arjuna. So an ordinary person cannot do like this. Like Prabhupada says here in this purport that no ordinary human being can show universal form and four-handed form. Only Supreme Lord can do this. So this is clear that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Again, next one important point Prabhupada highlights in this purport is like, what is the greatest injustice? So here Prabhupada is saying that there are these two points are very important. That one is that people, they speak about Bhagavad Gita, but what they think, that one who thinks that Krishna is an ordinary person and who misguides the reader by claiming that it is the impersonal Brahman within Krishna speaking. That one thing is Krishna is an ordinary person or like ordinary human being, and second is that Krishna is not speaking but impersonal Brahman, which is the topmost according to them, is speaking from within Krishna. That is the supreme power. So this is, Prabhupada says, this is the greatest injustice in this world. So we should fight against injustice. So that's why our acharyas, they are giving their clear understanding and real siddhantas of the scriptures. We cannot understand scriptures by our own intelligence, our limited intelligence and our limited sense of perception. So we require acharyas, we require some enlightened people to show us the proper meaning of the scripture, because scriptures are like a vast ocean. There is no depth of ocean easily to be, you know, understood. So scriptures are also like that. So many meanings can be derived from one word, but how we can understand the actual meaning, that requires mercy of Krishna and his pure devotees. That's why this path of parampara system is recommended for us to follow. So here at last Prabhupada says that seeing sun does not require lamp light. The original verses of Bhagavad Gita are as clear as the sun. They do not require lamp light from foolish commentators. So there is one incidence in this context when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he went to Jagannath Puri. And we know that when first time Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu enters the Jagannath temple and he sees divine form of Lord Jagannath, Baldev and Subhadra, then immediately he faints. And then the pujaris of Jagannath, they think that he is a strange person, and they try to like take out Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then immediately Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, he goes there and he takes Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to his house. Still there is the house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Those who have gone to Jagannath Puri, they may be knowing. There is house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. And the same house is also called Ganga Mata Goswamini Math. Before Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, before the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes, there was one great devotee of Lord Jagannath. Her name was Ganga Mata Devi. So she was also very extraordinary devotee, and because of her devotion, Ganga Devi appeared there in Jagannath Puri. So there is one Shwet Ganga, one place near the near the house of Ganga Devi, and the same place is the house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he took Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there, and when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to senses, then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya told him that you are a sannyasi and I see that you are very young. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was 24 years old when he took sannyas. So he was very young, and then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said that sannyasi is not supposed to wander here and there and dance in the public. What you are doing? You should know Vedanta. You should know Upanishads. So I will teach you Vedanta. So then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he makes Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sit there, and for 1 week he continuously speaks on Vedanta Sutras. Vedanta Sutra, Adhato Brahma Jigyasa, starting from Adhato Brahma Jigyasa. This is the first Vedanta Sutra. Many times Prabhupada quotes in his books and his lectures that this is the beginning of human life. Inquire about Brahman, what is the absolute truth, Adhato Brahma Jigyasa. This is our first duty to inquire. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he starts speaking on Vedanta Sutras, and he explains from the Shankar Bhashya, the commentary of Shankaracharya on Vedanta Sutra is called Shankar Bhashya. That is impersonal theory of Vedanta. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, for 1 week he speaks in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu this philosophy, this commentary of Shankaracharya on Vedanta Sutra. And after 1 week he asks Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that since 1 week I am speaking continuously, speaking on, and you are not giving any reaction, not speaking anything, not asking anything, what should I understand? Like, if you are telling something to other persons and he is not responding, then there may be two reasons. That one thing is that he may be understanding everything, grasping everything, and second is like he is not understanding anything. So what is your case? He asks Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu starts speaking. After 1 week he speaks, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that I can understand the sutras of Vedanta, but I am not able to understand the commentary. Then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya becomes very much amazed. What is this? Like, this commentary is meant to understand sutras. These sutras are like small formulas. So commentary is like explanation of these formulas. So this Shankaracharya commentary is meant to understand these sutras, and you are saying that you understand the sutras, you are understanding sutras, but you are not understanding the commentary. What does it mean? And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that this, your commentary, is like covering the sun with clouds. That means Vedanta sutras are themselves illuminating like sun, but your commentary is hiding the meaning. Then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya becomes stunned. What is this? What does it mean? Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu starts explaining the Vedanta Sutras according to Vaishnav perspective, Vaishnav philosophy. Then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya becomes very much amazed, and he then understands that this person cannot be any ordinary human being. Definitely he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So one who is really pure, he can understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But those who are having the business to cheat others, they cannot understand and they cannot accept. Like, we see that in Mahabharata pastimes, when Lord Krishna goes to Duryodhan, for having peace and not to fight. But then Duryodhan doesn't accept Krishna's words, and he even tries to attack Krishna. And then that time also Krishna shows his universal form. Then Prabhupada explains in one of the purport that universal form is not like this universal form which Krishna showed to Arjuna. Because here Krishna is saying that this universal form which I am showing you is never seen by anyone before. I am showing you because you are my dear devotee. And Krishna says that I am giving you special eyes to see, special vision to see this universal form. So by ordinary vision we cannot see the universal form of the Lord. One has to get special vision from Lord Krishna himself. So this universal form is different from that universal form which Krishna showed to Duryodhan. That was just like a partial manifestation of the universal form. So Duryodhan also saw the universal form, but still we can see that he could not accept Krishna as the Supreme Lord. Although he saw universal form, but because of his mentality, because of his enviousness from God, he could not accept God like Krishna. So Prabhupada one time got one argument. Prabhupada was giving class in London, and then one lady, she challenged Prabhupada, "Can you see God? Can you show me God?" Then she said, "I cannot see God." And Prabhupada said, Prabhupada asked devotees, "Can you see God?" Then devotees very simply, they just looked at the form of Radha Landanishwar there, and they see, "Yes Prabhupada, we can see God. Here is God, Radha Landanishwar and Sri Jagannath Baldev Subhadra." This is as simple for devotees to accept. But then that lady, she could not accept. Then Prabhupada said that you cannot see God because you don't want to see God. So Krishna is saying that Sarvasya Chaham Riddhi Sannivishto Matta Smritir Jnanam Apohanam Cha. I am situated within the heart of all living entities, and I give remembrance, I give forgetfulness, I give knowledge also. So this is our free will to accept God or not to accept. So one has to submit his free will to God. That is surrender. Surrender is not forcefully done. Krishna and spiritual master, they will never force us to surrender. It's completely our free will to surrender. As much we surrender, that much we will be revealed the secrets of devotional life. So then we can see that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that Mayavadi Bhashya Sunile Hoive Sarvanash. If one hears the commentaries of Mayavad, then his devotional life will be completely destroyed. So we should try to hear the message of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam from the bona fide representatives of the Lord coming in disciplic succession. That is very much important. And Bhagavad Gita is non-different from Krishna. Also there is one verse in Chaitanya Charitamrita that Krishna Surya Sama Maya Hai Andhakar. Krishna is just like a sun. So Bhagavad Gita is non-different from Krishna. So if we are associating with Bhagavad Gita, then definitely we are supposed to understand Krishna properly. Like also in the Vedic scripture it says that Acharyavan Purushah Veda. That means who can understand? Who can get the knowledge? One who is Acharyavan. Acharyavan means one who is following Acharyas. So that is very important, to follow the proper parampara. And then Krishna, he is very kind to all of living entities. So Krishna reminds us, like we always forget, like Krishna is speaking in the beginning of Bhagavad Gita 4th chapter that Imam Vivasvate Yogam Proktvan Aham Avyayam Vivaswan Manuve Prahu Manurikshavakya Abhruvit. That I gave this transcendental knowledge of Bhagavad Gita first to Sun God Vivaswan, and then he gave to Manu, and then Manu gave to Ikshvaku. Evam Parampara Praptam Imam Rajarishya Viru Vidhu Sakalene Hamahata Yogo Nashta Parantapa. And in this way, this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita was transferred in Parampara system. But in time, the Yoga Nashta Parantapa, that means this yoga, this Parampara system, the chain of Parampara broke. So Krishna is so kind that again he tries to establish the chain of Parampara through Arjuna. So Krishna is giving Bhagavad Gita again. Because we are so forgetful souls of this material world, we tend to forget all the time Lord and His messages. And Lord painstakingly, He comes Himself to re-establish the Parampara, and He sends His pure devotees, pure representatives to establish the bona fide Parampara system. So one place Prabhupada says that, but at present there are so many editions on the Bhagavad Gita, and then an innumerable interpretations on the Bhagavad Gita. But almost all of them don't accept Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So many interpretations of Bhagavad Gita, but almost all of them doesn't accept Krishna as the Supreme. So what is the benefit? So Prabhupada says that by doing these kind of interpretations, they are making good business out of Bhagavad Gita and Krishna. They are making money, they are getting name, fame, becoming famous persons. Oh, such and such person has written Bhagavad Gita. But this is a demonic spirit, Prabhupada says. How? Like demons, they like to enjoy Krishna, Lord's property, Lord's Lakshmi, but they don't want to accept supremacy of the Lord. This is a demonic mentality. So people, they want to interpret on Bhagavad Gita, want to just speculate on Bhagavad Gita, but they don't accept Krishna as the Supreme Lord. So this is a demonic mentality. Like Krishna is saying in 9th chapter 11th verse, avajananti ma mula manushim tanumashita, that those who are fool, they don't know me. They think manushim tanumashita, when I take a human form, they think that I am just an ordinary human person. And then Krishna is saying in next verse 9.12, mogasha moga karmana moga jnana vichetasa rakshasim asurim chaiva prakritim mohinim shrita. What is the characteristics of such demonic people? Rakshasim asurim chaiva prakritim mohinim shrita. They are covered with the demonic mentality. Asurim, again demonic, destructive, and mohinim, deluding energy, maya. They are completely bewildered by the illusory energy. They cannot understand Krishna as the Supreme Lord. So they are completely covered by the illusion. And the main reason of not accepting Krishna to be Supreme is enviousness. Why we are here in this material world? It is simply because of enviousness from Krishna. So Prabhupada, in the first shloka Bhagavad Gita lecture, first lecture, Prabhupada says that this Krishna consciousness movement is for those who are non-envious. And Krishna, in the beginning of the 9th chapter, what is the title of 9th chapter? Can anyone tell me the title of the 9th chapter? Yeah, the most confidential knowledge. The most confidential knowledge. Param Guhya Gyan. So, whom Krishna will give this most confidential knowledge? In the first shloka, Krishna is saying that Idam Tetu Guhya Tamam Pravakshyami Anusuyave Jnanam Vijnana Sahitam Yajgyatva Mokshase Ashubhat. So Krishna is telling to Arjun that I will give you this most confidential knowledge. Why? Because you are non-envious. Anasuyave. Anasuyave. Anasuya means he is not envious of God. That person is qualified to understand the secret and mystery of Bhagavad Gita. That person can understand the factual position of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But those who are envious, they cannot understand. So here Prabhupada says that idam jnanam, the word jnanam means pure devotional service. So see, Like, we can read Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is saying Jnanam Vijnana Sahitam, and very easily can be interpreted in so many different ways. Jnanam, okay, I will study science, philosophy and something like this. But this Jnan actually means devotional service, which consists of ninefold processes of devotional life. Navada Bhakti, Shravanam Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam. This is the meaning of Jnanam in this shloka. And then Krishna is saying Vijnana Sahitam. Then Jnan, we may have Jnan, like we all know, we all hear all the time, I am not this body and the soul. I am not this body and the soul. But are we able to realize our actual position as a soul? It's far away to realize. So that is called Vijnan. But for getting Vijnan, we have to put the Jnan into practice. If we, whatever knowledge we are gaining, if we put into practice, then it will convert into realization. But it may take some time. So we have to be patient. That's why Acharya is saying utsahat nishya dhairya. We have to be patient also, we have to be determined also, we have to be enthusiastic also. So, like non-envious people, they cannot accept Krishna. So there is one incident when Prabhupada was in manor, Bhaktivedanta manor. So Prabhupada used to meet so many guests, so many dignitaries, so many big personalities, they used to come and visit Prabhupada. Devotees used to organize for Prabhupada, Shyam Sundar Prabhu and other devotees. They used to organize meetings of Prabhupada with big people like George Harrison himself. He gave Bhaktivedanta manor to ISKCON. And then Ravi Shankar, Shishi Ravi Shankar, met Prabhupada there. And other many prominent personalities used to come. And there was one person, his name was Professor Zener. And he was a big scholar, and he also wrote one commentary on Bhagavad Gita in English. So he came to Prabhupada and he told Prabhupada that, Swamiji, I read your Bhagavad Gita completely, but I find that not even a single word tallies with the Sanskrit dictionary. How you came these meanings? How you got these meanings? How you put these meanings on these shlokas? Then, you know what Prabhupada replied? Prabhupada did not say anything. Prabhupada did not reply anything. Prabhupada just simply remained quiet and grave. And then that person, he was sitting, and then Prabhupada indicated one of his disciples to give some prasad to Professor Zener. And then he gave the Professor Zener some prasad. He took prasad, he left, Prabhupada did not say anything. And then after that professor went, then Prabhupada told his disciple, see, he has written Bhagavad Gita, he has written commentary on Bhagavad Gita, so do I. I also have written commentary on Bhagavad Gita, he also. But you see, there is one shloka in Sanskrit, Phalena Parichayate. That means, by the fruit, we can judge the tree. He has written Bhagavad Gita commentary, but no one became devotee of Krishna. The purpose of Bhagavad Gita is, Krishna is saying, Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Vraja. Give up all your so-called religions and surrender unto me. So this is the purpose of Bhagavad Gita, that we surrender to Krishna, we become devotee of Krishna. But when others have written Bhagavad Gita commentary, not even a single person became a devotee of Krishna. But when I tried humbly to comment on Bhagavad Gita, then we can see so many people of this world, they accepted Krishna consciousness. We can see the miracle right now also, that we are all having fortune to sit here now in Vrindavan Dham, and we are discussing Bhagavad Gita. This is the miracle of Prabhupada's Bhagavad Gita as it is only. So Prabhupada says that, I never claim that I have written anything on Bhagavad Gita. Whatever Krishna told me, I simply wrote that. I am just a pen of Krishna, Prabhupada said. I am simply the pen of Krishna. I have not written anything from my side. So this is the real presentation of Bhagavad Gita. When we become devotees of Krishna, we try to surrender to Krishna, we try to act on the essence of the scriptures. So this is the magic of Srila Prabhupada. And we can see now that all over the world, this message of Bhagavad Gita as it is and Prabhupada's transcendental books is changing the lives of so many people, and people are becoming good for having good fortune to accept Krishna as the Supreme Lord, and they are practicing devotional life, and our life is leading, moving towards the ultimate success, towards Krishna. So this is only due to the mercy of pure devotees. That's why we have to follow the parampara system to understand the mystery of Vedic scriptures. So we are fortunate enough to get this Gaudiya Vaishnava parampara system under the able guidance of Srila Prabhupada and his pure representatives. So we are very much safe. Like today, His Holiness Gopal Krishna Maharaj was giving Bhagavatam class, and some devotee asked that why we should not hear Bhagavatam from other sampradayas. So Maharaj gave very nice and crystal clear answer that because Prabhupada says that I have a certain mood. So if we read Prabhupada books and we listen to Prabhupada, then we are able to associate with Srila Prabhupada, who is the pure bona fide representative of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement. Others are also pure, can be pure devotees, but we are committed to Srila Prabhupada. So we should be like loyal to Srila Prabhupada, and everything is there in Srila Prabhupada's books. So this is sufficient for us. Like Prabhupada said that, even Prabhupada said that don't read Bhakti Vinod Thakur. First, you completely read my books thoroughly and try to digest it. Otherwise, you will misunderstand. Because there are so many high statements in scriptures, and according to time, place and situation, different kind of explanation by our own acharyas. So we cannot understand it practically. But Prabhupada, he has given in very practical, down-to-earth approach how we can practice Krishna consciousness in this present scenario. So we should stick to Prabhupada and just follow Prabhupada, and all success will be there. There is no doubt in it. Hare Krishna. So if anyone has some question or some comment regarding today's discussion, can add. I cannot claim that I can answer all the questions. My knowledge is very limited, but I'll try to share whatever I understand.
We forgot our material things before we are doing so many nonsense, so we don't remember Even our in family life, just like our brothers, sisters, mother, father, what they were doing, we don't remember them, we just forget, we leave our parents, we leave our friends, we just come here. So when we come here, we got this knowledge, so we don't want to remember. Just like Prabhupada once gave the example of Sarv Damodar, Prabhupada his mother left her body. So he said, I want to go. So Prabhupada said, you see, what you going to do? Let your this thing they let them do those things, whatever their duties are there. Why you want to waste your time? You think it over and let me know. Then Chakravarti thought one night, what should I do? Then he said, whatever Prabhupada said is okay for brother. We know Prabhupada, I will not go. So this remembrance, forgiveness, everything is given by Krishna. So he is putting us more and more in this association of devotees and giving us good knowledge of this realization. So when we are in the realization, we understand that now we are not in the material world, we are in the spiritual world. So when we are in the spiritual world, we follow this one. But still when we are in the spiritual world, then we are still envious of each other sometimes. So when we have this knowledge that we shouldn't be envious of any of this one, then why still we have this enviousness nature that we have envious, I am envious of you, he is envious of him, somebody envious of me. So why this, when the remembrance and forgiveness be, why this again this envious is coming? Can you put some light on that one?
Hare Krishna. There is one saying, Prabhu, that old habits die hard. It's very difficult to give up our old habits. So although we are getting this good fortune by the mercy of Vaishnavas, pure devotees, Srila Prabhupada and his representatives, to practice spiritual life, this is the chance given to all of us to come to the consciousness of spiritual world, of course, definitely. But because we are the marginal potency of the Lord, we are Tatastha Shakti. So we are always in the margin. So we can go towards spiritual realm and we can go to material world again also. So here, this risk is always there. So that's why it is said that scriptures are like Kshurasya Dhara. The spiritual path is like the razor edge. So it's very dangerous also. So if we are getting this opportunity, then we have some responsibility also. It's not so easy, like it's not very easy to transcend these material modes. Still we are in this material world and we are affected with the modes of passion and ignorance most of the time. And according to our association also, we are affected. Every moment we are affected. We have not become transcendental. We are on the path of transcendence, but what is the way to transcend these modes? Krishna is saying that mam chayo avyabhicharena bhakti yogena sevate sa gunana samati tetan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. That means one who is performing devotional service in this manner, avyabhicharena, that means completely unalloyed, he can transcend the three modes. So it's not very easy to transcend the three modes, and not very quickly we can do. Overnight we cannot become Prahlad Maharaj. It will take time. According to our past association, according to our sanskaras, we have all that burden. So, but pure devotional service is very powerful. That is there. There is negative side and there is positive side also. That if we become humble, that although I am not qualified, but devotees, they are so merciful that they are giving me this opportunity to become purified, to get the mercy of Lord, and I am getting this opportunity to perform devotional service, so I should be humble actually. Not that, oh, I have become devotee. Oh, I have read Bhagavad Gita, I have read Srimad Bhagavatam, I have heard so many lectures, I have given so many lectures, and now I have become devotee. This is the problem actually. When we think that I have become a devotee, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur says that Amido Vaishnav Emati, when this mentality comes that I have become a Vaishnav, then what will happen? Amani na have ami. I will not remain amani. That means I will not remain humble. And the first beginning of knowledge, Prabhupada says, is amanitvam, humility. Humility is the beginning of knowledge. But when I think that I have become a devotee, I have become a Vaishnav, then I cannot remain humble. And then I will expect respect and recognition from others, and then in this way I will lead my path to hell. So this risk is always there. So we have to be always conscious. That's why again and again we have to hear from pure devotees. Again and again we have to check with Prabhupada's purports, what attitude, what kind of mentality I must maintain so that I don't become affected by Maya. Because when we are practicing devotional life, then there is also test of Maya. When we are doing something, there is test also. So Maya is testing us each and every moment. Not every day, not once in a year. Every moment we are tested. So if we are following honestly, if we are trying to become simple, then by the blessing of acharyas, we can pass the test. By our own strength, by our own intelligence, we cannot. Bhakti Vinod Thakur says that nija bala cheshta prati bharosa chhadiya. That means I give up the dependence on my own strength and my own endeavors. Although we will try to increase our sincerity, but I am not dependent upon my own efforts. I am dependent completely upon the mercy of pure devotees, of Vaishnavas and the Supreme Lord. So our acharyas are teaching us this mood of humility. Whatever we are doing in devotional life, we should do it in the mood of humility. But when I think that I am doing this, then I expect recognition, and then I try to judge others. Oh, he is doing wrong, he is doing wrong, and I try to, you know, make my spiritual life damage. So we should not judge others. That's why acharyas are teaching us that we should not judge others. Like one nice quote of Jesus Christ, I like that: don't judge and you shall not be judged. So we should not try to judge others. Only acharyas can judge, guru can judge. We are not supposed to judge anyone. We are supposed to judge ourselves. I should see where I am standing, how much lacking I am having to progress in devotional life, how I can improve myself. For that I should try to serve humbly all the devotees to get their blessings. That's why devotional service is volunteer. I should try to voluntarily serve Vaishnavas so that I get their blessings, and by the blessings of devotees all the difficulties will be gone away from our devotional path. This is the secret which I understand. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Prabhupada was challenged on his translations of the verses.
Yeah.
It happened when Prabhupada existed. It is happening now as well. And unfortunately it's happening right now inside the moment itself. I mean, you're aware of it. I give classes in base, Delhi. So devotees are not very enthusiastic after they're not inspired, because their preachers or their counselors are saying Prabhupada is imperfect. Because recently in Bangalore, Chetan Charan Prabhu quoted few verses of Gita and said Prabhupada translation is incorrect. Happened very recently. So when I speak about Prabhupada, there is no much, no more curiosity. Curiosity is lost within the devotees.
I don't know, like maybe I don't know about your statement. Like I'm not sure about like what Prabhuji has said, in which context he has spoke something, and then how can I comment?
He says Prabhupada is imperfect.
I cannot say unless I hear. Like so many people say, like that person said like this, and then this, you know, like there's one story Prabhupada says, right? You know, Bhagwan Pandit Bhut, there is one story. There was one minister of one king, and then he was like, some people, they made some conspiracy against him, and they didn't want him to come near the king. So they put rumors that like that Bhagwan Pandit is dead, and now his ghost is coming. So then when Bhagwan Pandit tries to go to meet the king, then everyone like puts the rumor that he is like ghost. So then king's orders to kill that person. I don't know. I have not seen. So how can I comment about this place?
Also,
I'm sorry.
The verse which you write.
Yeah.
The verse itself is incorrect. I mean to say, it's been changed. I hope you're aware of it.
No, the meaning is of okay. Don't you see whatever we discussed today was correct?
What we discussed was correct. I'm happy that you quoted about Prabhupada. He said we should challenge, we should fight.
Yeah.
You are inspiring.
Yeah.
Your speech was inspiring.
Yeah.
But
so we should.
Which you read from the Gita, the book is edited, unfortunately.
There may be some editings, but it's not that like this shloka, this translation is giving Mayavadi meaning or not accepting Krishna as the Supreme Lord. There may be. Why?
Because his translation is being edited again.
I am not aware much about this, but I have some small little knowledge of Sanskrit. So when I am reading, I have some knowledge of Sanskrit, little bit. So when I am reading these shlokas and meanings, I don't find much difficulty in understanding the meaning, and I don't know what you are talking about, so I cannot say without my
question about not being important.
Because this is
no, we all know who Prabhupada is to some degree, with the pure devotee. So how can we make it?
What should my answer be?
I would say that your answer would be that if you study the astrology and the Vedic calculation of the distance to the moon, for example, and you may ask to the scientist, is this, the Vedas say that the distance to the moon is this? No, logically it is false. Every scientist can say it's false, but we believe it's true. So Prabhupada is always.
So like we discussed that Prabhupada says that phalena parichayate, by the fruit we can judge the tree. So you can see this Bhagavad Gita is still being distributed, yes, and still so many people are becoming devotee, they are getting connected to the parampara system, yes, no, this is your thinking. But you see, you come to our temples, you go to different temples, and you can see so many people coming, they are getting awareness of Krishna consciousness philosophy. We should not like remain in our own well. There may be one perspective of seeing things, there may be some complication, but it's not that everything is wrong. So we should not like see like in a narrow minded way. There may be some problems, but it's not that everything is going wrong. We should see those who are sincere, those who are genuine, they want to realize Krishna, they will realize Krishna. Instead of so many these kind of conspiracies, we may think conspiracy or so many like changes or this that happening. But those who are serious, those who are simple, they will find their path, go back to Godhead. So we should be serious about changing ourselves first. First I become a good devotee. I try to realize what acharyas are saying, then I will get the potency from them to present this philosophy in a proper manner. So if we think that something wrong is going on, better I correct myself, better I improve myself, I take the responsibility to present the philosophy as it is given by Prabhupada. Does it make sense to you? Isn't it right? There may be something wrong, but I should be responsible, not just simply to point out, but to take responsibility to represent Prabhupada's teachings. That's what like I understand. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who was spreading the Vaishnavism?
There were many acharyas coming in Vaishnava parampara, like Lord Brahma. From Lord Brahma to is came to Madhvacharya, one of the prominent acharya of Vaishnava darshan, Madhvacharya. Then from him to our parampara, it came to Madhvendra Puri. And there are so many acharyas in line which are not mentioned, but only prominent acharyas, their names have been mentioned. So one is Madhvendra Puri. And then from Madhvendra Puri to Ishwar Puri, who was the spiritual teacher of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And then from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this revolution started. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself is the Supreme Lord Krishna. So he descended to create this revolution. But from the acharyas, this line is coming. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki, Srila Prabhupada ki. Hare Krishna.